Hello. I'm the mechanical, intelligent, roving, advanced neurodata access. You may call me Miranda. What you are seeing is a vessel known as Extra. Unfortunately, we cannot travel very far as we are low on energy. The power source is 20th century video games. More specifically, energy that is converted from a game's completion or specific goals within said game. You are viewing this feed from the year 4978. Simply put, the 50th century. The universe is mostly androids, or other mechanical beings created as far back as the early 30th century. The only known droid, with a neuro link to appendages, capable of controlling these video games is a droid we have dubbed Dima. Also known as Droid Minus Arms. Dima was initially a droid, created in the mid-28th century.
Future may not look as cool. Scene does not reflect actual future.
When he didn't live up to human expectations, he was deactivated and placed in cold storage. Never checked on, never activated. Never in all these centuries able to relieve himself. If you have ever seen when Austin Powers was thawed out, you will know exactly what I mean. While our entire crew is capable of their duties on board the Starship Extra, they are not programmed to operate these remote hands. After an extensive search, it was determined that only Dima can telepathically control these remote hands, and thus, complete these ancient 20th century video games. Once these games' specific goals are satisfied, the energy meter will rise. When it is up to full capacity, our engines and guidance systems will perform at maximum, so that we can pinpoint where to find more video games, as well as the machines that will play them. If Dima fails in his quest, our energy core will eventually drop down to zero. When that happens, we will either be drifting around the galaxy, singing 100 bottles of beer on the ship for the rest of our existence, or comedically fall through the endless void of space, like a Looney Tunes cartoon. Whichever the writers decide is funnier. Now that you are aware of our situation on board the Extra, it is time to join Dima and broadcast his first video game playthrough.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening.
I guess we're on. Hi, I'm Dima. What's my ideal partner? Well, she likes kung fu movies, SpaghettiOs for breakfast, and daily foot rubs.
But Dima, we don't have any feet.
If you boys are quite finished.
Sorry, Emily.
Your game today will be Smurf rescuing Gargamel's castle. It was released in 1982 for the ColecoVision.
Now, your target score will be about 200,000 points. That will, in turn, power our ship so we can reach the next available system for supplies.
Got it. We'll play some games, gas up in Pittsburgh, and grab some jerky from the 7-Eleven.
I don't get it.
Never mind, Jacob.
We'll be monitoring all your progress, Dima. Good luck. We're all counting on you.
Thank you, Leslie Nielsen.
Woof!
Do I have to clean this up?
We suggest you play skill level 1 to familiarize yourself with the game and its controls.
Well, this certainly is colorful. Well, I guess we go right into the... fence? What just happened?
Hello, Dima. Rusty Key here. This is but one of the many obstacles your unnamed Smurf must jump over. Press the joystick up to jump in place, or diagonally to jump over hills and other things made to impede your progress.
Oh, okay. Got it. All right, that was easy. One of those days when you're jumping over a teeny tiny hill and you die from landing in a tuft of grass, please say yes. What can I say? I like Smurf butt, and I cannot lie. Hey, this is actually kind of fun! Whee! Woohoo! Rusty's advice certainly was helpful. There were different kinds of jumps you can do in this game, as I found out the hard way. I found myself confused. I had already saved Smurfette. By all logic, this game should be over and I can make it just in time for happy hour. As Rusty explained, the game just starts over from the beginning each time you rescue Smurfette, and that many games of the time were like this. Right, it's like the Smurfs meets Groundhog Day. Well, the game says Smurf rescuing Gargamel's castle, not Ned Ryerson's basement.
Phil?
That's not fair, I made that jump! Oh, come now, I can't even fall off a half an inch high hill! Say that 5 times fast. I don't think I want to know what happens if that Smurf energy meter runs out. For the love of... It occurs to me they never really established which one of the hundreds of Smurfs this is. Considering Smurfette doesn't kiss him, his name must be Friendzone Smurf.
Much, much, much later.
Hey, wait a minute, I didn't want to make that kind of a jump. Rusty, what's going on with the controls here?
Don't look at me, kid. I didn't make this game.
And for the 80th time, I've rescued Smurfette. Heck, if all the games of the world are this easy, you guys will have enough power to get the ship clear through the next century.
Say, Mutiny, I've had the most sensational idea. I think we should increase the game's difficulty for our little friend here.
Indeed, Muley, if it's a challenge he wants, we'll give him one.
So, is it my imagination or did that hawk just fly backwards?
That there is impossible. Hawks cannot do that.
Yeah, we'll tell him that. And down I go like a fainting goat. I already had this feeling I'm in for quite a long play, so I decided I'd better find some sustenance. Hi, United Federation of Pizza? Yes, I'd like to order 30 of your well-endowed Sicilian pies. Yep, sausage, eggplant, all the obvious phallic symbols you can fit on a pie. Oh, can you put some 10W40 on the side? Perfect! Okay, deliver to the 4280 Ford Fermium Delta GX. Yeah, look for the bumper sticker that reads, "My Volkswagen Beetle is on the honor roll." Well, I'm glad he gets the joke.
And now back to Winston the Wise on You Stole It TV.
Welcome back. Been a while, huh? I've had a few issues with... alcohol. Anyway, one thing that dropped a long time ago was a great video game all about robot kind. Now don't be scared, kids, because the robots in this game are robot monsters, and we're not all monsters. In fact, most of us are not monsters. I'm not, for example. Not sober anyway, but the game is called Escape from the Planet of the Robot Monsters. I've no idea where this planet is, I only know its name, Planet X. I've never been to Planet X myself, not sure I'll ever go there either, other than in the context of playing this game, that is. It was developed and published by Atari Games and was released in 1989 in the arcade and for several home systems including the Commodore 64 and Amiga, Amstrad CPC, Atari ST, MS-DOS, the SAM Coupe and the Sinclair Spectrum. It's essentially a shooter-style game in the vein of the classic 1950s sci-fi B-movies when robots were all the rage and everyone wanted one in their home. Anyway, Planet X is a manufactured planet that is home to the research facility of the voluptuous scientist Professor Sarah Bellum. She has a huge brain. Unfortunately for the very intelligent Professor Sarah Bellum, the planet is invaded by an evil alien race called the Reptilons, who capture her and force her humans to build a robot army that will be used to take over the Earth. A bit like Amazon. Escape from the Planet of the Robot Monsters is a one or two player game where the player has to rescue the scientist Professor Sarah Bellum by shooting the enemies in a series of maze-like levels, while at the same time releasing human hostages along the way. Your mission objectives are: transport all hostages back to your ship, destroy all robots, rid Planet X of the evil Reptilons, find and rescue Professor Sarah Bellum. In order to do that, you have to find and activate levers that operate the escalators. In the game they're called electro stairs, and they can be used to access the next area, and of course you can collect things to help you. In this case it's gems that increase the strength of your ray gun. I went to school with Ray Gun. Nice guy. I went to school at the same time as R2-D2 as well. About 8:30. You can also open food lockers and eat the goodies inside to gain extra health. If you don't have enough enemy Reptilons to keep you busy, you can also shoot computers and machines in the levels for extra bonus points. But try not to shoot the human slaves, you're supposed to be rescuing them after all. The arcade game had a few very interesting hardware features. Firstly, its sound was controlled by a MOS Technology 6502 chip. And it also had speech, driven by a Texas Instruments chip, a TMS-5220.
Your mission: transport all hostages back to your ship. Destroy all robots. Rid Planet X of the evil Reptilon. Find and rescue Professor Sarah Bellum.
Completely unaware of this, the player controlled the game using something called Hall Effect joysticks. These were a type of analog joystick that allowed 16 directions of control rather than the normal 4 or 8 for arcade games. The game is played from an isometric perspective, and in between levels, you have to fly your ship through an isometric maze while carrying the humans you've just rescued in that level. The main fun in the game is in the rescuing of humans and shooting enemy robots, though. It's a very colourful game, with a good soundtrack and lots of speech to keep you informed of what's going on. The graphics are great, it looks great, and it plays great, so it's certainly worthy of your time. Well, that's all from me for now. Goodbye, and bollocks.
Do you think if I rescue Smurfette enough times, I'll get to first base?
Did I just hear him right?
Sadly, yes. I say we field strip him in his sleep and sell his parts.
Mutiny, it seems our friend Dima is performing at this game quite well.
Indeed he is, Muley. He will most certainly provide our ship with the power it so desperately needs.
I agree, but just to mess with him a little bit more, let's increase the difficulty, shall we?
That there is an excellent idea, Muley. Ho, ho, ho.
Whoa, these hawks are faster now, and what, they swoop too? Swooping down to attack while flying backwards. That takes skill. I had a choice. I could die of exhaustion, or I can die by landing on a tuft of grass. I chose the latter. Admit it, you would have done the same. Okay, it's bad enough when hawks defy nature and fly backwards, but to fly through solid ground? Impossible! I'm beginning to notice a significant change in the game's skill level. The artificial intelligence is getting smarter and more of a pain in the tuchus. I suspect the drones in the control booth may be tampering with the skill level. How did I reach this conclusion? Call it a hunch. Jeez, they're evil. They're sadistic. They ought to try politics instead. Okay, fellas, if that's the way you want to play it.
I just want to tell you both good luck. We're all counting on you.
He did it.
Woof.
Was that my food?
It seems we owe you our thanks. Not just for your help, but also for the pizzas. Thank you for thinking of the crew.
The crew? Right.
Well, I hope you've had a chance to rest up. Now that we've reached the Componium system, we were able to pick up a few supplies.
I've been meaning to ask, what supplies did you need anyway?
New games, of course.
What?
They call it the Nintendo Entertainment System. It has more capabilities than the ColecoVision, therefore, they'll be able to program video games that could potentially be harder. Here's the next game you'll be playing.
Oh, nuts!
My name is Dima, a Droid Minus Arms, and a passenger aboard the Starship Extra. This is a video game, in case you couldn't tell. Since I'm the only droid on this vessel with thumbs, it's my mission to play every single game out there just to keep this hunk of junk in space.